AppSumo's Black Friday week continues with drop number 2. The theme today is automate everything. There are 4 tools in today's drop. I'm going to go through each one of them, show you how they work, and you can decide if you want to add them to your collection. The way these AppSumo drops work is you get the best price if you act right away. After 7 days, the price increases around 10 to 15% depending on which pricing tier you choose. This video is not sponsored other than by your clicks. I have my link down below in the description. If you're planning on shopping AppSumo this Black Friday season, please consider using that if you want to support my content. Let's get started with the first product, Meetn. Meetn is a video conferencing platform. It lets you do one-to-one meetings, group meetings. You can even stream to social media platforms if you want to be a live streamer. Here's what the platform looks like. I'm inside of a Meetn right now. So essentially, I could record my meeting, stream to any of these destinations, and even share my screen. You've got really nice big buttons here. This kind of feels like your grandma's Zoom. Like, you don't have to hunt for the buttons. They're all there. We've got mic, camera, and speaker buttons. So if I wanted to mute my mic, just click right there. If I wanted to turn off my camera, very easy to do so. And yeah, the speaker is to mute the sound coming out from other people. So don't be confused if your mic is working and you hit the speaker. Flashbacks of about 5 years ago. There are some view options here. We have plenty of options. So you can see a gallery view, the active speaker excluding yourself. This is a platform you can use with a lot of users. You can go up to 24 videos max. It even does webinars, but you have to go up to tier 2 to get access to those features. In fact, there's quite a few features not included on tier 1. And as soon as you move up to tier 2, you get 3 meeting rooms and way more storage. If you're having large meetings, you'll be happy to know that there are breakout rooms, so you could give a large presentation and then have everybody split up into breakout rooms to discuss things in more detail. And there's text chat here as well. You can message to everybody, just to the hosts, private messages, or do a Q&A style. They even have widgets so you can preload your slides or other graphics that you might want to display during your presentation. Overall, I think it looks good. The interface might be a little dated to some, but I think having those nice big clear buttons are actually going to be more beneficial than anything. As far as quality goes, most of the AppSumo reviews that I saw where people have been using this over months were largely very happy with the service. There was some people complaining about quality of audio or maybe some artifacting in video, but often that has to do with the upload speed or just the overall bandwidth of the people on your meeting. If you have slow internet at home, you're not going to have great looking video when you use video conferencing. It doesn't matter if you're using Zoom, Google Meet, or Meetn. I really like the idea that you can do a live stream with this tool, connect it up to social media, and stream directly there. It's very beneficial. It allows you to hit a larger audience at once and not have to deal with any other third-party software. I also think it's really cool that after your event is done, the link that you shared becomes a replay link. Often I don't have time to attend live events, but I did want to see the presentation. And if I watch the replay, I can watch it at 2x speed. So that is Meetn. If you're sick of paying for Zoom or you've got a large webinar service that you pay thousands of dollars a month to, you might want to check this one out. Next up is ClickRank, an SEO tool that promises to automate your optimization efforts so that you can rank higher on the search engines. Now, one thing I really like about ClickRank is it's very forward thinking. It's not thinking of SEO in the old days. There's a lot of AI tools baked right in. It's actually paying attention to what it thinks about the LLMs observing your content. It's really cool. Let me show you. Now, this is going to be a speed run through this application. If you want to see a deeper dive of ClickRank, let me know in the comments. I'd be happy to go through this in exhaustive detail. I really like this tool a lot. There's 4 or 5 different components, main areas of the tool. First of all, we've got the AI toolkit. I'll go through what each one of these are in brief. Then we've got our more traditional SEO tools, but it's AI powered, so it can really make things go faster. If you're used to doing website audits and they take forever, this can speed things up a lot. We've also got analytics and reports. Some really great, thoughtful reports are built in so you can find low performing pages, things that are not getting clicked on, so that you know to optimize them. It just brings those right to the forefront. We've also got some keyword tools. What would SEO be without keyword optimization? We've got research as well as tracking here, so you can track keywords across different websites that you're trying to rank for those particular keywords. And you know, this is important because it's got this little fire emoji on it. There is an AI SEO agent where you can basically just ask about your performance on your website, how you can improve things, put together an action plan, critical issues that need to be solved. This is a really cool feature. It's like having an SEO agency on contract that knows everything about your website, except it's right here and it's AI and it won't laugh at you if you ask it silly questions. By the way, the setup process with this tool is very easy. There's essentially two things you'll want to do. First of all, when you enter in your domain name, they're going to give you either a little script of code you'll want to put on your website, or if you're using WordPress, they have a plugin so you don't need to bother with that. In addition to that, I do recommend connecting up to Google Search Console so that it can grab all of the data that Google knows about your website and bring it into the tool. If you are privacy focused and you try to avoid Google products, Google Search Console is the one that I recommend you reconsider. Essentially, you're not giving any data over to Google. Instead, Google's telling you what they know about your website based on people's search behavior. So you're showing up in Google search results, they're just gonna let you know if you're getting clicked on. So that can be pretty valuable information. Okay, let's just go through each one of these items. I'll kind of describe it in brief. If I had one criticism to say about the platform, it's that it's kind of slow. You click on it and there's that little loading screen every time. If they could get rid of that, it would feel a lot better, but it's, I guess, not that bad. I think the fact that it shows the loading screen makes it feel even slower. All right, so we've got an AI content writer. You can write full blog articles right here inside of the tool. As it says, never stare at a blank page again. Create SEO optimized content in minutes. Just add in your topic, your language, your country, and then begin writing. Let's try it out. The best AppSumo deals of 2025. Starts off by giving me a title. I'm gonna go with their first suggestion here, 9 words, top AppSumo deals of 2025. Unlock incredible savings today. We'll continue to step two, select an intro. Again, I'm gonna go with the first choice. And then we've got our headline structure. I'm just grabbing one here, not even reading it. And finally, it's gonna use the AI writer to actually create an article for us. It's really odd how LLMs creating content for us has become kind of just like not even impressive because so many tools do this. If this were the only thing the tool offered, I probably wouldn't be so excited about it. It is cool that it's baked in, but personally, I don't really like using tools like this. I don't want the dead internet to take over quite yet. Maybe it already has. I don't quite know, but I'm gonna keep doing everything I can to make real human content as long as people watch it. Okay, so here we go. I've got my article. It looks fine. I mean, it definitely would need some work in order to be something that I would want to put on my own website, but you get the idea here. We can copy it to our clipboard and proceed. The other tools, I think, are way better. So first of all, a AI model index. What this is gonna do is tell you whether or not you are blocking the AI models, the LLMs, the Claudes, the ChatGPTs, the Geminis. Can they actually view your website? You might want them to, you might not. We're not judging here. You go ahead and just enter in your URL and they're gonna look at the robot.txt and find out if you're indexable. Now, I know personally, my website is not. I use Cloudflare and they have a little checkbox you can click and then it doesn't allow any of the AI models to scrape your website. So they say, I'm not entirely convinced they're not gonna ignore that file and do whatever they want anyway. Clearly they did that to train the models in the first place. Next, we're gonna skip this search volume here for a minute because I wanna show you the AI compatibility tool. This is very similar to the AI model index tool and I think you could look at this and be a little bit confused just at a glance until you start using it and then it becomes very obvious that they're different things. This will check a specific piece of content on your website and help you understand how ChatGPT, Claude, Gemini would actually understand the content on the page. What they would see as a strength and what they would see as a weakness. I've already connected this up to my website, so I'm just gonna have it analyze one of my articles here. So we'll do building a CRM with Softr. So Softr, former sponsor of the channel, hopefully future sponsor of the channel as well. It is now analyzing this article. And there we go. We can see we're doing pretty well. ChatGPT gives it 100. Cohere, I haven't even heard of this model, but you can see all of the different scores and then I can view details on each model and it'll say, oh, you know, it needs more authoritative sources or like this one, the brand public reviews. I don't use G2, Captera, or Trustpilot as a basis for my recommendations. I mean, I don't really trust those platforms myself, but that's just me. Okay, we gotta wrap this up because there is so much to this this tool. Again, leave me a comment down below if you want me to go through this in more detail. But essentially, we've got website optimization where we can go ahead and look at our website, see what needs to be improved, and then basically have the AI do it for us. Like my about page only has 2 clicks. That's not very good. All right, I can go ahead and just click auto optimize and it's gonna improve that page. Take a look at the metadata, take a look at the description, see if there's a way it can make it a little bit more clickable, more interesting. If you don't wanna do that on a page by page basis, you can do bulk optimization where you go under bulk titles or bulk meta descriptions, select all of the pages you want to be optimized. You can click them all at once or just go through. And then as soon as you have a few selected, we've got some new buttons that appear where we can optimize all of those pages at once. It could do things like rewrite the title of the page or give you a better meta description. The reports are super thorough. They've got a really great interface to build out new reports. I'm very impressed with this part of the tool. So it's going to pull in this data from Google Search Console. You won't be able to get a lot of these reports if you don't connect things up. But here is a low click-through rates by page report. So these pages are stinkers. They're not doing very well for my website. They need to be improved. So whether you have one or many websites, you can choose a plan that works for you. This tool is not really built for agencies to use on their clients. The max plan is 8 websites. But if you are an entrepreneur managing everything on your own, this could literally save you having to contract a dedicated SEO agency, especially if you already know a little bit and just don't have the time to do things. You can guide the AI and get things done in a fraction of the time that it would take to do manually. Yeah, if you're already interested in SEO, you know some of the terminology, just go ahead and scroll through the features here. I think you're going to find that this tool actually does quite a bit to make your website more clickable. And yes, SEO still matters. LLMs matter, but your website is still the way customers are going to find you. So don't give up on it. Continue to innovate, continue to make your website better. The last two tools in today's drop, Robomotion and Albato, are a lot more traditional automation tools, at least what I think of when I think of automation. Things like Zapier, where you might have a flow and there's a trigger and some actions happen, and then you get the end result you're after. That is what you're gonna get with both Robomotion and Albato. So you might think they're very similar tools, but they're actually extremely different. Robomotion is what they call robotic process automation. To me, the real clear distinction here is the fact that Robomotion can control a keyboard and mouse. That means they can automate anything you could do on your computer. You can set up Robomotion to control a computer, either your own local computer by installing some software they provide or running it in the cloud. Robomotion has been on AppSumo before, of course. They've actually been part of Black Friday. They were part of Black Friday last year. They have now diversified a bit here, and they've made their product a lot more accessible to end users. Prior to the advent of their For Users section, this tool was really meant for hardcore computer users, people that wanted to automate as much as they possibly can. They've got a ton of very powerful integrations. You'll see LLMs in here. There's Llama and ChatGPT. There's also all of the productivity tools that you typically use. We've got our Google apps. There is going to be social media platforms. There's a lot of tools that it works very well with to do things you can't do any other way. With the advent of the For User side of things, they've got a little shop opened here where you can grab agents. They're pre-built. They can do things that you want them to do. Most of them right now are kind of just around the principle, like I want to make silly AI images. In fact, they integrate here with Nano Banana. So that seems to be kind of the trending thing that people are trying to take advantage of. But I love this direction for the company. If there's more pre-built usable agents out there, it's going to make this tool a lot more accessible to a lot more people. Albato, on the other hand, has a marketplace with some presets. In fact, there's over 1,400 presets included here, but it's not shying away from the fact that it is a power user's tool. I mean, to be clear, Robomotion is still a power user's tool. It's just that Albato has not done anything to also move into the consumer-centric area. So with Albato, it's a lot more like a traditional Zapier type of tool. And I always recommend with these types of tools, just look at what apps are supported natively. And with Albato, you're gonna get a ton. Now, of course, you can always use webhooks and things like that. You know, we're just on A here. It's gonna keep loading forever. You're gonna be able to use webhooks and, web requests to go out and grab data. It does not have the ability to use a keyboard and mouse. So unlike Robomotion, where it can literally connect up to anything. But I mean, look how many platforms are supported. We are only on G. It seems like I've been scrolling forever. The automation builder itself can be very simple. I like this list view. If you want to have more of a branching effect, you want to use branches, you can open up things inside of Canvas, and then you just simply add in, you know, you start with a trigger and then you add in your actions. So email could be an action and I want to send via SMTP, or I can add whatever integration I need. So if you know you want to pick up an automation platform because you're just sick to death of those Zapier fees and you're not quite ready to wade into the self-hosting of N8N and you're deciding between Robomotion and Albato, I would think, well, are there things that I want to do I can't do any other way? Maybe I've tried using other platforms. I can't figure out a way to automate a certain task. Then give Robomotion a try. If you're simply trying to eliminate your Zapier fees, then I think Albato is the way to go, especially if you check the integrations that are already there. You're not a developer. You don't want to deal with webhooks. Well, then definitely look into Albato. I should mention that Albato does have an AI aspect to it now. Unfortunately, it's not a true agent where you can just say, make a connection between my Gmail and my productivity tool so that as I receive new emails, they are logged. That would be awesome. That doesn't exist right now. It's simply just a tutorial finder. So you have to start with how to, and then it's going to help you find relevant tutorials. But hey, it's better than nothing. I hope this roundup has been helpful. There are four great automation tools available to you right now. Remember, you need to act within the next 7 days to lock in the best price. I'll be watching in the comments. If you've got any questions, feel free to hit me up. My AppSumo link is right there in the description as well. And thank you to everybody who has already been clicking that. That's going to do it for this video. I will see you tomorrow with drop number 3.